Hi, I'm Marco from REDcatch. I'm one of the developers of the REDtoolbox, and in this short video, we'll look at the usage of Geoid models in the REDtoolbox version 3.1. Geoid usage is possible in the post-processing and image shift tools. We'll first look at the post-processing and geotagging tool. First, you set up your project as usual. Then, in order to use a geoid model, select the geoid height for the output height. This opens a drop-down list of available geoid models. By default, REDtoolbox includes the EGM 96 15-degree model. You may add additional models by pressing the Manage Geoid Files button. This opens a different mask. In order to add a new model, you need to enter a new, unused, and unique label, one which helps you to remember the model and its usage. Next, you press the Select File for this label button and select a valid GeoTIFF-based geoid model to be loaded. Once selected, REDtoolbox loads and internally saves the model. This means you may even remove the original file. Once the program response was successfully saved, you can quit and we can now see in the drop-down list our label, which corresponds to the previously selected file. We select it, and that's it. Now, once processing is finished, REDtoolbox will apply the geoid model to obtain autometric heights for the triggers. In this case, we speed up the actual processing part for this video. Once processing is finished, you may check and investigate the exact height computed for each trigger by opening the log file titled REDcatch underscore output. There you may find the computed heights for each trigger. The PDF report also automatically includes the original file name used for the geoid model in this processing run. This we can see here. As mentioned before, you may also use geoid models in the image shift workflow. First, we switch over to the image shift tool. You can select your geoid model in the same drop-down list as for the post-processing tool. Note that models are shared between tools. Any model added here will also be available in the post-processing tool and vice versa. Next, we process a small batch of images using the geoid file selected. Once the batch has been processed, we can also check and investigate the exact height computed by looking into the same REDcatch underscore output log file in the output folder. If you wish to remove a model, you may simply select it from the drop-down list using the Remove File part of the Manage Geoid Files mask. Simply press the Remove File from REDtoolbox and confirm. The file and label will be removed from internal storage and will no longer be available for you to use. This concludes this short demonstration of the usage of geoid models in the REDtoolbox version 3.1. A 14-day free trial of the software can be downloaded from our website displayed on the screen. For more information about the REDtoolbox and REDcatch, please visit our website. Thank you and see you soon.